And William Abbott, also actor, comedian, puppeteer. I put him down as a ventriloquist, but he's a puppeteer at heart. And if you've seen Soul Heaven, then you know he's a singer. William Abbott.
Yes.
William, tell us about your background before you talk about, you know, getting to work on Soul Heaven.
Well, I've been working with children for about 25 to 30 years
Wow.
now. And
musically or as a puppeteer?
Well, originally just working in after-school programs and as a Head Start assistant teacher and as a family worker in Head Start and then at the Boys Club for a year and, you know, just mostly working with children. So that high energy and that I can't explain it, but when you have to get their attention and keep it.
Right.
Type of thing is
doing that in front of an audience.
And for the past 9 years now, I've been a puppeteer.
Mm-hmm.
7 years as a marionette puppeteer in Central Park, and that led to me. I could always do the ventriloquism, but I never had the confidence to do it. But that gave me an audience to start to practice on, and then when it was time for me to leave the marionette theater, then now I'm doing my own puppetry.
Mm-hmm.
I ran into Brian, oddly enough, to a third friend of ours, William Rivers, who was working on Soul Heaven with Brian, and he said karaoke, and I'm like a big karaoke fanatic, to the point where I've entered contests and I won $10,000.
Wow, okay. Yeah. I mean, I got a little bit into karaoke. I mean, my sister and I used to go, there's a place called Duet 35, and I used to tape it. Now, you two met through the third person who actually was going to be here. But,
yeah, Bill Rivers.
Unfortunately, couldn't be here, but we'll have him.
Another brother who we connected really quickly, you know.
Right. You went to school with him?
He and I have been joined by the hip since the 10th grade.
Wow.
Literally.
Okay. Well, definitely we'll, you know, have another show and talk about that. We have a clip to show now. It's from old school, I guess. I think it starts out with...
That's Miss Biddy Presents.
Oh, it's from Miss Biddy Presents.
Yeah.
Okay.
She couldn't be here today.
Oh.
Either.
Well, we'll see her later, and
she
hopefully
might be with Mr. Rivers.
Oh. When she, I understand that she's undergoing some sort of upgrade.
She's
side grade.
She's connecting with her younger sister.
Going to her inner young. Youth.
She's very plucky, but her sister is. Worse than she is, and sister's now coming to visit her, and we're going to have a little. It's going to be some problems, and I know that they're coming. So, you know, she went out to connect with her sister.
What's her name, Miss? Shididi?
Miss Biddy.
Miss Biddy. No, it's my younger sister.
The younger sister.
Sister's name is Miss Shididi.
Miss Shididi.
She reminds me of Millie Jackson. With her attitude, the way she talks.
Another blast from the past in the 70s.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, we're going to look at this clip then of Miss Biddy Presents. Is it from it? Is it from that? Or what is the... I forgot the title of the clip. It's your puppets, and it's more than Miss Biddy.
It's Miss Biddy Presents at this point.
Right. And there's two more. Okay. So let's take a look at this clip.
Ladies and gentlemen, William Abbott, the puppet man.
Take my heart and take my soul.
this bitty variety show with master puppeteer William Abbott. This week's guests are Little Legend, Ronald Haney, Lorraine Amaker, Rachel Ford, Mick and his Magic Basketball. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Biddy.
Oh, Mr. Puppet Man. Oh, he fell again. Oh, how y'all doing? I'm Miss Biddy. This is my show. Now, on this show, what we do is bring you entertainment, talent from all over the world. And what those puppets just did is what puppets love to do to puppeteers. Yank them down! And they sure got my friend William Abbott. He is something else, boy, I tell you. Now, the puppets, that was Rachel and Mick. And I'm going to tell you something. Mick comes from Japan, so we have talent from all over the world. Now, my grandchild, Tizzy, she's not been feeling too good lately about herself, you know? So I sent my niece, Lorraine. Lorraine got a head cold, but I sent her over there to talk to Tizzy, because Tizzy's not feeling too good, and I figured, you know, maybe Lorraine can get through to her, you know? So take a moment and just check it out for me and see what they're talking about, okay? And I'll be back with you in a minute, okay? Puppet Man! Puppet Man!
No, I'm talking about some of our black leaders. And?
And what?
Who's the president?
Oh, yeah! Rock Your Mama!
No, not Rock Your Mama, Barack Obama.
Rock Your Rock. Rock Your Rock. Yeah.
Who's the president? When I was a kid, you couldn't even think about being president if you were of color.
So I could be.
Yeah.
Then a lady, the, you know, head lady, you know.
Well, there have been, but they call them the first lady.
I don't want to be. No, I'm going to be the president.
You want to be the president?
Yes.
All right. Well. Someday you can be the president.
Well, I'm.
Okay, I love that. So, William, tell us about this character, because obviously that wasn't Miss Biddy. That's.
Oh, no, that was Tizzy. That's
Tizzy.
That's Miss Biddy's great granddaughter.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's a little girl that gets into things and then tells every things that she sees and hears that should not be.
Repeated.
Yeah. That shouldn't be repeated. You know.
Who are these people?
He's my third cousin, once you knew, on the left side, carried it too. His name is Georgie, and that's his fiance, Skanky.
It's Shaquanda.
Oh, sorry. Skankwanda.
Okay, Turkey, here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna go into the kitchen, stuff your big old behind inside the oven, and I want you to set it for 4,000 degrees. We're gonna do this feathers and all. We're gonna get some satisfaction anyway. I'll stuff you later. Now go ahead on in the kitchen. Go ahead. Gobble gobble. Get on now. Gobble gobble. Go ahead.
We have a small host of characters. We have Baby Boogers, Tizzy, Miss Biddy, choke the chicken here.
Okay, so I was going to ask about this.
Yeah.
It seems to be your favorite. Of course, we you know, we miss Miss Biddy, but tell us about this character you have here. Let's hear.
Well, he's basically he's one of our house pets. He just kind of, Miss Biddy's been threatening to cook him for quite some time, but he. What did she say? She don't like rooster or something.
The meat is a little tougher.
Yeah, the basic stop. The basic he has a tendency to speak only when he wants to, or to he stays in trouble a lot. You know, sometimes I keep him with me so that he doesn't start acting out in public.
I'm gonna choke the chicken.
Don't choke the chicken.
And also, there's another one of my favorites. His name is Clinton, the house dog, right?
Oh, yeah.
He chases me.
Stop.
Okay, well, let's talk about your singing for a little bit, for a moment, because it only existed for a moment in Soul Heaven. Brian, you told us earlier about, you know, where the inspiration for Soul Heaven, you know, to do this tribute. I loved it. I loved working on the show, and was glad to see, you know, so many performances of it, you know, as well as the rehearsals, and you're getting up to the point of actually being able to showcase this play, this musical. You played Ray Charles.
Yes.
Tell us about, first of all, I guess auditioning for the show or the musical. Did you know Brian beforehand? Is this when you
met? Did not. No,
okay,
that's when we first met.
So talk about that for a second.
Well, we had came down to the television studio where we was doing a little rehearsal, and in the middle of the rehearsal, Bill Rivers, who's his best friend, said, "I know somebody who can do Ray Charles." So I'm like, okay. Hey, <I'll> come down. So the next day, William shows up, and he auditioned then, and then, you know, he did a great job doing Ray Charles in the show. Very good.
You're ready to have some fun. I'm going to need a little help from you, okay? Do it, you do it with me, okay? Here we go. Hey! I want to there for you? Now, come on, now I'm tired. Y'all, please. Hold on, man.
The night before the show, he told me that he didn't learn one of the songs, which was on the CD. So,
and then I never got the CD.
He said he never got it.
I'd have crazy. It today if I did.
But anyway, he was one of the first. He was one of the first acts on early, and he was running a little late. So when he came in, they played the song that he didn't learn.
Oh.
And I'm sitting there saying, wasn't he learn the song? And that overnight, it's like, but he didn't. So he kind of added to it. But being that Ray Charles was blind, he kind of ad-libbed, like he's trying to find the keyboards. And people thought it was kind of comedy and stuff, but they made switch.
It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
Sing, yeah.
as somebody that was on the camera.
Yeah, but I said, that's what an entertainer does. You know, he's rich to entertain people, so he knew to do something to make that entertaining. You know, he went after that and did What I Say, which was a Ray Charles classic. And he knew that all the way through. You know.
Thank goodness.
Yeah.
I mean, if you hear the name Ray Charles, we want to hear that song.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, that
was what I said, yeah.